Hello friends, today I am going to show you how to attach devices to your router so that even if a person is knowing your password cannot attach to it. So this is a feature that you can access from your router's homepage. So for that, accessing that, open your browser and go to routerlogin.net. When you enter that, you will be asked for the username and password. The default username for that page is admin and password is password. If you have changed it, enter consecutively. So when you enter these, a page similar to this will appear. So when this page appears, what we gonna do is that we have to add a device to the router and make it completely isolated so that even if a person knows the password is not able to attach to it. So I'm just saying that two of my devices are actually connected right now, and I want a third device to add, and for that we will go to wireless settings. So in wireless settings you will see a setup access list. In setup access list, all the devices that has already been added will show up. If you want to add a new device, please ensure that this checkbox on the top named turn access control on is unchecked. It should be unchecked. When it is unchecked and if you want to add a device, then click on add. A page will show up where you can see all the devices that are currently added or something to your router. So if you want to add a device, just simply ask that device or the person that is using that device to enter the password of your router. When he enters the password, simply click on refresh, and that device, if it has been connected, it will show up. So since like this device has been connected and it's showing up, I just want to give it a name so that I can identify it later through the name of the device. Like it's an 79 of mine is connected right now, and the MAC address you just have to put the device name, and MAC address is actually fixed. You don't have to change anything in that. When you have done this, simply click on add. If there are more than one devices, you can simply click on adding more and more devices. So when this is done, what you wanna do is to make your router pest free. So for that, just simply click on this, check this button, turn control on, check it, and click on apply settings. When you click on apply settings, the router will save the settings and will wait, and you will have to wait till it saves and comes back to its original state. It will take some 5-10 seconds. So when it's come back, your device is completely secured and no other device can access your Wi-Fi even if he or she knows your password. Now next thing you can do out of it is that you can do a QoS setup. What is this QoS setup? QoS setup most probably stands for quality of service. Like if you want to add priority to a device, that my laptop or this cell phone should be having more of the bandwidth when I am using all the devices consecutively. So in this QoS rule, you can actually add up a device and make it high or low. So since I have already added, you can see this all four devices are already added. I just want to edit it. If you have not edited it, means if you don't want to edit it actually, and you just want to add a new device that you want to prioritize the device that you have recently added, click on add priority rule. The screen similar to this will show up. Click on the MAC address, then different devices having different MAC addresses will show up. Click on the device that is actually you want to prioritize or deprioritize. Click on the priority to highest or lowest or whatever you think like, and click on the add button. This if that device has already been added, it will show duplicate name policy or something, and so you don't need to add that, just simply need to apply that. When you apply that, the setting has been applied to this page. So since this page has this setting has been applied to this page, you can click on to apply. When you click on apply, the setting will save up and will take some time to return back. If you do the setup of QoS, don't forget to turn on this access thing. Means you have to check on turn internet access QoS on and then click on apply. When you click on apply, then update settings will go on, it will save to routers, some time will take, and will revert back to your main page. So when you have done this, the main thing you can do is to change the password. You can change your password through wireless settings. You can go there, change your password to something very simpler like 12345 or Facebook or whatever. Don't keep a password that you actually keep for your Facebook or Gmail, because someone may use it indifferently, right? That's all. Thank you. Hope you enjoy this video.